Man, Big Backstreet with Coach Shit. Y'all see who in front of the lens, man. I appreciate y'all always rocking with me, man. This is the second time around, man. We got my homies, man. We got family in here. We got the boot in here. We got Texas in here. Studewood in here. All that great shit. Backstreet.
And here, man. Life, you hear me?
I appreciate that, man. But
I let the young goat go first, you hear me?
Hey, okay.
Goddamn, you heard what's going on. Trey Studewood, hey, man. Strictly hustle out the once again. Down with the movement, man. If you know me, you know where I'm from, man. Studewood, Texas, man. Gonna forever hold it down, man. You know what I'm saying?
Static the main man. I don't need to really say much. Static the main man. At me, man, Static, you heard me?
Man.
CEO, spokesman of Strictly Hustle League Tech. Well, this is CEO of Strictly Hustle, you know what I'm saying? But spokesman of the fucking whole movement, your dad. Strictly Hustle.
I remember
it was a lifestyle, you heard me?
They were hustling in the pandemic. I still got my mask up there so well, man.
You feel me?
So they been grinding a minute, man. Yeah. It's good to see y'all still be consistent. Y'all go with whatever they got out, man.
Appreciate
but
that.
You already had said it off camera, man. Did Zero snitch or not?
I wouldn't call it snitching because a camera was involved. You know what I'm saying? In the streets, from what the streets saying, you know. You old boy done bought a camera out there, you heard me? So, you know, he told on himself with that. Mm-hmm. You dad?
You been keeping up, because I know you from, let them know where you from.
I'm from New Orleans, oh my bad. I'm from New Orleans, you heard me? I mean, I already know you hear it in the talk.
We already.
Man, yeah. Avenue, you dad? New Orleans, E70126.
Hey, shout out
you
to
dad? Me. That's yeah. Where I'm from. Texas, Louisiana, Texas, you heard me?
Peace, man. Why the tighter inflation, man? Is it worse with all going on? What's that about?
Exactly. You know, for people that don't know what inflation means, that means like when we go into a depression, like what happened in the 20s, that means everything skyrocket. You see how everybody talking about how eggs expensive, gas expensive. So I just came up with that name myself, your dad. And I'm just, you know, I'm coming back from what was mine, you feel me? I'm touching on different subjects. I'm a very versatile rapper, so when you listen to my music, you might get political shit in one song, you might get some conscientious shit in another song, you won't get that, I'm talking about hustling in all my songs.
Oh yeah, it's tough, but I enjoy the view.
You heard it, so, you know, I'm touching on different subjects on inflation. You know, I'm talking about what's going on in the church. I'm talking about
what's in the church? Wait a minute.
You know, I got a song on there called Church Folks, you heard me? You know, I come from a good family. My father was a deacon. My mother was a usher, you feel me? So I came up in the church setting, but I came up in the church where you was able to go and talk to the pastor, and the pastor knew everybody by their name. Mm-hmm. So some people might think I'm a tag in the church, but I'm not a tag in the church that I grew up in. I'm talking about these churches that you can't go to, if you can't pay your rent, you can't even go down these steps. And these churches that got ATM machines at the goddamn door, and it's a fashion show. Mm. So that's the churches.
You keep it, okay.
So that's the churches I'm talking about. The churches that ain't going to the community and helping the people. The church is not the building, the church is the people. That's what the Bible.
Why do you think so many people, I say the Gen Z babies and the millennials and all them, have strayed away from the church? Why do you think the church ain't as big as how it used to be when you was growing up?
That's a good question. I think because family is not promoted as much as it was when I was growing up. You know, I'm an 80s baby, you heard me?
Shout out to them 80s
babies. I grew up, you know, a little bit in the 80s and the 90s. So I just don't think that family is promoted more. Like, you know, it's all about having a bunch of hoes and hoes having a bunch of niggas and all this kind of shit. So I think it's because families is not promoted in the black community anymore.
It's kind of like
we still have it, but it's not as popular. You know what I'm saying? Because I was asked why I wear my wedding ring. You won't be ashamed to wear your wedding ring on your video. No, not at all.
What the fuck? Man, that's enough. That's weird.
I'm not ashamed of it.
But
at
that's
all.
The industry. So I ask this shit all the time. Would y'all? You already married? You not right? You getting married? Okay.
Player.
I don't know.
He's a senior player, though. You heard me?
Would y'all marry a woman that didn't believe in God?
Nah, I got you. You gotta be God.
Well, she just not into the religion thing. She just real atheist.
Nah,
this
gotta be something you gotta at least know, because you gotta know that man is real. Man.
I wouldn't marry her because, I guess you could say I'm a mama's boy. You know, my mom, I gotta get my blessing from my mother. Mm. You know, and so, you know, that's the thing. And I feel like a lot of these artists, is a lot of men now are more emotional. Women are more masculine, and a lot of these niggas is more emotional because of a father not being in the house, a masculine presence not being in the house.
So what would be y'all message to the young black men coming up in the society today?
My message to the young black man coming up in the society today is don't be afraid to be yourself. You heard me? Don't follow the crowd. It's okay to stay out the way. Mm-hmm. You heard me?
Yeah, I'm gonna say shit, take care of your family.
Yes.
Take care of your family. People say, you know what I'm saying? People say, you know what I'm saying? Family and this and that, man.
Child,
family,
brother.
Everything. Family, everything. Take care of your family. Yeah. Stack up as much bread as you can.
Mm. We love this shit.
Okay.
Like, we love this shit. And I also want to say this. You know, don't put a timeline on your music career. Yep. Your music career. I've been doing this shit since I was in middle school. I might not be rapping forever, but I'm going to always be tied into this music game. See, the thing is with me, I like to do artists and development. I like to mentor young artists. I kind of like to minister through music.
Do you like the CEO role being behind the scenes, or do you like the rapping?
Love it.
Which one you like more?
I like the CEO role because I'm not really a camera guy. I don't know there's a lot going on, y'all. But we stay consistent. So, you know, I just dropped. Then Trey, he finna come through with Blue Smoke 2. Mm. Shit gonna be a motherfucking classic. You heard me?
Louisiana man, like that.
And shit, he finna drop. Like a lot of niggas, you know, Houston my second home, you heard me? And I got a lot of love and respect for Houston. But a lot of niggas be on too much of that Hollywood shit. You feel me? Like you would look at a nigga's stories, you would look at everything a nigga do. But your pride won't let you say, bro, boy, you a fucking fool. Damn. See, the thing is with me, I ain't ashamed to say I'm a fan.
Yeah.
I ain't ashamed to say your shit nice. Cause I know my shit nice.
Because you come from that generation though, that you was more.
I'm not insecure.
Okay.
I'm not insecure, and I'm gonna do my thing. More. Houston should be.
Facts. Talk.
Houston should be crunching. No disrespect to Atlanta. Houston should be crunching Atlanta. Houston should be crunching everybody. There's too much talent down here.
We started a wave too. Like we started.
There's too much talent.
Shit, like them that we started. The Southern
right.
Boys and shit. Ghetto boys, man. You know what this motherfucker supposed to be.
Don't get me wrong. I ain't saying I know the music. I know the music game. Mm-hmm. Just like the NFL. You feel me? This is a competitive sport. Mm-hmm. But this the thing what niggas don't understand about sports. LeBron James, they be playing against all these different teams and they be competitive. Like, yeah, nigga, I'm gonna score the most points. Mm-hmm. But when all season, them niggas playing golf and at each other's houses for barbecues and shit.
Shit, man. When y'all get that first big check, what's the first thing y'all buy?
I let Trey go first.
Shit. To be honest. If I ain't buying nothing for the fam, that shit, I'm trying to flip that shit gonna stay in the booth. You know what I'm saying? I gotta flip that in the booth, man. You know what I'm saying? Get that to the, you know what I'm saying? Get it to, you know what I'm saying? Flip that mud. Let's go ahead and make some more music, man. And that's what they let. That's all you gotta do. Let's make some more music.
Definitely, like, you know, you know, first the family, you feel me?
Mm-hmm.
First the family, you know. What, when you say a big check, how big this check is?
I'm gonna say $250,000, $250,000.
$250,000?
Yeah.
Okay, like, yeah.
They give y'all a labor deal.
Okay, like, well, that's gonna go back, like, with sugar, like, some money like that. That's going straight back. Fam, I'm sorry.
Y'all buying nothing nice.
I'm on some, like, business shit. Yeah, I would treat myself. But not too much with $250,000. Okay. Like that's a lot of money, but that ain't a lot of money when it comes to this
music.
So like that would mostly go back into, you know, the company
and you know music shit.
Of course, yeah, I go bless myself with some nice.
Some nice, man. Yeah. You gotta treat yourself, man. Yeah. You gotta work too hard. You know what I'm saying? So you pay yourself first and then.
Right, definitely.
For real, man. I'ma keep that footage and hold y'all to that. I'm like, y'all but see y'all ball. I'm like, nah, nigga, what happened? Back into the business. Yeah. Is rap as hard as y'all make it? Right, to actually blow up? Is it that hard to actually make it?
That's a good question.
Yeah, that's a good question, man. I ain't gonna say it's hard, and I ain't gonna say it's easy.
It ain't easy.
It ain't easy.
But I'm not a rapper, so that's why I
ask
y'all.
It ain't easy. This is the thing about rap, dude. Like, that's different from everything in the world. Like, it's either you got it or you don't.
Uh-oh.
You hear me? Like, okay. It ain't a second string trick head or a second string static. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
True that.
Like, it's either you got it or you don't.
You're leading them astray, man. I appreciate you being, you know, a stand-up guy. A lot of niggas even... hate to say that your age, they still be trying to pop and be popular and do crash dummy shit and steering the youth the wrong way. So it's always good to have stand up.
OG Ridge, man. T Cuff, Youngster with Flow, man.
Shout out Youngster, man. He signed that big deal over there at Sony, man. That's dope.
Big salute.
How proud of y'all of him? Or y'all proud of him?
Words can't explain it.
For real, though.
Words can't explain it. But like I always say, you hear me? They can sign with anybody they want to. This home, Strictly Hustle Latex, this home. You know, this the roots. This where it all started from. Man. This the gym. This where it all started. You know what I'm saying? So it's love. Proud of my nigga.
I didn't get a chance to say shout out to you, man. Shout out to you. This is what you're doing right here. This live.
Man, y'all fuck with me from day one. Still, y'all ain't never switched up like the rest of them, but it's all love, man. For real, for real.
Static
and Trey, man, on the back streets. I gotta ask also, man, did New Orleans fall off as far as rap?
No, we still got Lil Wayne alive.
Okay.
That's the goat, man.
Okay.
I ain't gonna say New Orleans, that's a good question. New Orleans didn't fall off from rap, but New Orleans lost its sound.
Yeah, it got a little touch.
You know what I'm saying?
Static.
I feel like when they got
expound on that though, cause I do agree with you, and I feel like the homie, what's his name, Raw 49, trying to really bring it back, but I feel like
it is on top of years, over a century, but we lost our sound.
Do you feel Cash Money is the biggest record label that ever came into hip hop?
Definitely.
Definitely. The YouTube's all that great shit.
Google, you know what I'm saying? Google Trey Hayes, or you know what I'm saying? Instagram, you know what I'm
real
talking
shit,
about?
You hear me? We got 60 videos, you hear me? 60. Like, I'm mad because it ain't 100.
Mom, come
bro, stop.
I'm mad because it ain't 100. It's going
60 videos, that mean y'all doing something right.
60 videos. Shout out to my nigga Marvel, you hear me? Yeah, shout out to my nigga Marvel, man. And Marvel,
Marvel Films? Marvel Films, yeah.
Man, look, shooting 2 videos a month.
Man, and then I asked, I said, who be shooting all the videos? That's the first thing they said.
Marvel.
That's it, man. Yeah. Back Streets with Coach shit, man. My homies just always love me.
If you do want to come fuck with us on some real shit, you just got to be ready to work. That's all I'm going to tell you. You got to be ready to work, and you got to believe in yourself, and you got to be self-sufficient. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to give you the game. Trey going to give you the game. You know what I'm saying? But it's up to you how you do it. You know, you give a man a fish, you going to eat that dick. Mm. If you give a man a fish, you going to eat.